Organisms placed in each kingdom have certain basic similarities, such as their external and internal structures, their means of obtaining nutrition, and their methods of reproducing. These provide the characteristics for defining each kingdom, such as the bacteria and archaea kingdoms. Bacteria and archaea have some similarities. They are both single-celled microorganisms without a nucleus. Like protists, they usually reproduce by binary fission. However, they are biochemically very different from each other and live in very different environments. Bacteria and archaea have a range of different body shapes and forms. Some are shaped like a rod, corkscrew, or spiral, and others are ball-shaped or spherical. Some bacteria and archaea have appendages such as a flagellum, which is like a tail, or a number of flagella to enable them to move. Bacteria are a large and diverse group of microorganisms that live in a wide variety of environments and play important roles in many of the Earth's ecosystems. Some bacteria are considered bad because they are pathogens that cause disease or infections, such as Staphylococcus bacteria, or the one that causes whooping cough. Others are considered good bacteria, like the Lactobacillus bacteria group. These good bacteria are rod-shaped, one of the most common bacteria body shapes, and help with digestion. This group includes the bacteria used to make yogurt. Some bacteria perform vital functions in the environment, such as actinobacteria. This group of bacteria live in soil, decomposing organic matter vital for new plant growth. They are also found in oceans, including deep-sea environments. Some bacteria are heterotrophic and, like fungi, absorb the nutrients they need from other organic matter, while others are autotrophic and make their own food like plants do. An example of autotrophic photosynthetic bacteria is cyanobacteria, or blue-green algae. Cyanobacteria are usually spherical or cylindrical. They often form colonies that might resemble long chains. The agar jelly in this petri dish provides a nourishing environment for the growing bacteria colony. Like plants, cyanobacteria can pink chlorophyll and obtain their energy from sunlight through photosynthesis, which is why they were originally classified as a simple form of algae and placed in the plant kingdom. Archaea are sometimes considered the more primitive bacteria and are renowned for the extreme environments that they exist in. Archaea live in a wide range of environments and thrive in extremely harsh anaerobic conditions. They're found in places like hot springs, swamp sediments, sewage treatment plants, and volcanic vents. Some even live in the digestive tracts of animals, including cows and humans. Many tolerate extremes of temperature, salinity, solar radiation, or pH. In fact, they appear to survive in conditions similar to those on Earth in primitive times. Our understanding of archaea increased dramatically in the 1990s, when scientists decoded the full DNA sequence of a type of archaea called Methanocolpacoccus genetici. This species thrives at temperatures of 185 degrees Fahrenheit and produces methane from carbon dioxide. It is a methanogen, one of three broad physiological groups of archaea. Methanogens get their energy by converting carbon dioxide and hydrogen into methane and water. The other two types of archaea are known as halophiles, which prefer very salty environments such as the Dead Sea, and thermophiles, which obtain energy from sulfur compounds and thrive in relatively high temperatures. Some archaea can thrive in conditions that are both highly acidic and hot, such as acidic hot springs at a pH as low as 2 and temperatures in excess of 212 degrees Fahrenheit. They are sometimes referred to as thermoacidophiles. Our discoveries about the characteristics of bacteria and archaea demonstrate how technology can advance our knowledge. Sometimes, this can even lead to the development of new scientific theories. Even today, different scientists use different classification systems. One classification theory places bacteria and archaea in the same kingdom, Monera, based on them being single-celled organisms without true nuclei. Other biologists split Monera into kingdom bacteria and kingdom archaea, based on the differences displayed by organisms. The ongoing debate over the five kingdom versus the six kingdom system represents a significant change to the biological classification system of living things. It demonstrates how scientific theories can change over time as new evidence emerges.
If you like this video, you can find it and so many more at clickview.net. Sign up for free today.